this is McLarnon.
And Ned again. Two big boys.
Looks like you and Barry Beck.
Yeah, right. McLaren, well, I'll tell you what, I give him a lot of credit. Burnett's got size on him, but he hangs in there. You know what, Gene, I don't understand something. You know, look at this fight. Jarrett Burnett, correct?
Yeah.
It's spelled G-A-R-R-E-T-T. Why wouldn't it be Garrett? You know,
he's Canadian.
Yeah, I mean, it's just... But you know, when you play against a team 12 times in a year, you're always thinking, you got to be thinking, hey, we cannot let them get an edge at all times. So you got to be ready for it.
Now that wasn't a fight, really. That was a calling card. This is what we're up to tonight.
Yeah, this is just sending a message saying, you guys think you're going to steamroll us tonight, you're going to have to earn it and pay for it. And that's all it is, just sending a message. Not only for this game, but for the next four that they got, or five they got left. You know, talking to Bill Barber earlier, he feels there's two lines on the Thoroughbreds team that could hold their own in the NHL.
There's his reaction to the fight. He seems to be...
Yeah, he's pretty happy. He's pretty happy.
Your applause for Steve McLaren.
Minutes in a classic game, and we've got another business here.
McLaren and Burnett again.
Yeah, they went at it in the first period.
Yeah, listen.
And Brian Lewis wants somebody too.
It's the Gillette. Wednesday night fights of the week. One had the edge and then the other, and they're separated by the linesman, Hedeberg and Gagnon.
I'll give McLaren a lot of credit. A lot of credit for, you know, he's outsized. He's... Yeah, this series is long from over. I'm sure Frank's skating in front of their benches and asking them what they got for Christmas, I'm sure.
All right, so besides the players they lost,